Good morning, friends and fellow traders. This is Doug Campbell with Right Way Options, and this is the morning market prep video for December 8th, 2021. Oh my goodness, we have an all or nothing market. Either we're rushing in or we're running for the door. And this morning we're having a very volatile pre-market as well, with Pfizer coming out with news that three shots can neutralize the new variant of COVID. So pretty interesting market situation as we're up here testing some resistance levels in the charts. We're very extended in the short term. But what does that mean for today? Well, how about we settle in? Let's buckle up. Let's get ready for the hump day edition of the morning market prep video. Good morning once again, everyone. Thank you so much for being here. I do truly appreciate it. My goodness, we have a busy day today, so how about we just get right to it, take a look at these charts and see if we can gain some information about how we may want to approach the market for today. First off, let's take a look at the Dow. I'm going to actually go to the actual Dow and Dow Jones, and I want to measure something here. If I measure right here and look over in that little box right over there on the right-hand side of the chart, if I measure from this level right here, our low, to where we ended up yesterday at our high, well, almost 1,800 points in the market in the Dow since December 1st. Obviously, the majority of that coming in the last couple of days. Oh my goodness, what a rally back to the upside, as we've kind of decided we don't care about the variant, which is fine, you know, perfectly fine. It looks like it's not nearly as severe as that everyone was originally worried about. But we do have to kind of worry about the fact that we are now facing this resistance in the chart. We blew right through this area right here, just like it wasn't even there. Blew right through that yesterday, and we now have this downtrend to challenge us in the chart. Now, just a few moments ago, we were looking lower, and then we got news from Pfizer. Whoops, let me go to the diamonds. We got news from Pfizer that apparently in their testing that three doses of vaccine will neutralize the new variant. So all of a sudden we got real excited here and pumped up in the pre-market. But let's keep in mind, guys, we are pretty darn extended here in this market, and we cannot rule out the possibility of a rest or a pullback. And I want to point out how painful that could be. If we pull back into here just to test this price support, it's about a 700 point pullback. So that could be kind of painful. Be careful chasing into stocks as we continue to extend. As a matter of fact, what I did yesterday is I took profits on trades. I did not buy anything new yesterday in a long position as we continue to try to stretch, because I see quite a little bit of risk if we do just move a little bit lower. That could be painful for those. And with the volatility of the market, it really isn't out of the question. Now, I'm not trying to predict what's going to happen here in any way, shape, or form. I'm just trying to say there is danger here. So make sure you're planning your trading carefully and that it fits your trading style. Now, let's take a look. What could we do from here? Well, obviously, we know we can, if we can push on through this level, we have additional price resistance levels in the Dow that we could challenge. Maybe Santa Claus is going to come along here for the next few days. We'll see. But we do have some interesting things that we have chosen to ignore. One, for example, is that we chose to ignore our productivity number yesterday, which came in at the worst level since 1960. We just completely ignored it. We completely ignored that the costs of production continue to go up. And we have to remember that on Friday, we have a CPI number that could really point to that inflationary problem in the market. So just kind of keep that in mind as we stretch and stretch. We still have those potential stumbling blocks out there that could occur. And if you caught the news last night, Evergrande did officially default. They missed their grace period payment And now it's a $300 billion default. It will have ramifications in China for sure. Now, whether that trickles over here to the United States, can't say, but they are suffering some pretty heavy real estate problems over there in China. Can that trickle over here? Well, we'll see. But watch that closely. Let's take a look at the SPY, SPY. Big strong move back up, and the SPY has probably the best chance of breaking out to new highs here again. And notice that we're up here testing these levels, and this morning we're trying to pop once again. But we also want to recognize the fact that this is price resistance, and we've struggled with this before as we popped up here and then pulled back from that point. And that was prior to us learning about the new variant. So watch that carefully here. We are kind of stretched in this market, and we are testing these resistance levels here in the chart. Can't rule out the possibility of a pullback just because we're so stretched, maybe a little bit of rest in the market, but we also can't rule out the possibility that we could push right on through to that upside move. It would also, and remember guys, I'm not trying to predict the market here. I don't want to put all of the hype and prediction that you get in other places. I'm looking at the technicals of the charts, and I want to lay out for everyone the possibilities that exist. So we certainly have the possibility we could pop through. We certainly have the possibility that we could pull back. And we certainly have the possibility within this little range here that we could just rest here in that SPY chart. So we're gonna have to be a little bit careful. What that means is as we're elevated here really strongly in the SPY, there's considerable risk if you chase into new stocks right now for that chance of a consolidation pullback could be pretty punishing, particularly if you're an option trader. So watch that carefully. Now, keep in mind that what we also could be forming here, if you take a look at this chart, we could be forming a inverted, here, let me get the right drawing tool. We could be forming an inverted head and shoulders pattern. So it's possible if we set out here and rest and place a little rest pattern in here, that we could create that inverted head and shoulders pattern in the SPY chart. So we have to also be looking at the full picture of this chart and what could potentially occur. Let's take a look at the Qs. Now the QQQ has a few more challenges here than the SPY, and we know that we have been challenged, we were being challenged by this, the unbelievable valuations of these charts. And keep in mind guys, if you saw that report yesterday on CNBC, we have hit record numbers of CEOs and insiders selling. And one of the things that they have been selling for, partially taxes, but another thing that they're selling for is because they've mentioned in the report is the high evaluations of these stocks. Now, kind of keep that in mind. If the insiders are selling, that should be a clue to us not to just rush in and snap up everything they are trying to unload, because that could prove to be a problem. But as we push back up here, we have a substantial risk here in the chart that we're going to see if we can push on through. Keep in mind, we had this high failure and rejection in that chart. So we're right up here testing that again. And I'm really not sure anything has really changed here all that much since we rejected that high. So watch this up here if we were to run into some resistance and see a little bit of selling. And I'm not saying panic, run for the door, everything collapses. Maybe just a little bit of a pullback, maybe a little bit of a profit taking, maybe a little bit of rest, and we can calm down some of this volatility that we've seen in the market. And I don't know about you, but I am voting for some calming of this volatility so that we can get back to a better edge in technical analysis. So watch that close. And then let's take a look at our IWM. Now the Russell, rallied back substantially, but I got to tell you, probably the best chance of an additional downside move here in the market. And remember, it's pretty common, guys, when we test a low, that we come back and at least make a low, a higher low in that chart, that we test some support levels in that move. And let's keep in mind here in the Russell, we have a massive amount of price resistance in this chart that we still need to try and break back through. We have this upside trend that we failed, creating that price resistance point as well. And if we add in the downtrend, look at that right there. We have this great big commingling of major resistance levels in the chart that we'll want to keep an eye on. So watch that carefully here as we try to rally back up. Russell could be one of those that runs into a little bit of trouble. Let's take a look at our VIX. Our VIX pulled back nicely yesterday. Finally, we got a nice relief in the move, but our volatility still remains rather high. Notice that we continue to remain above that 20 handle area, and that's an area that I have mentioned many, many times as a major support or resistance level in the chart. You can see it all through here where we served as resistance, where we've served as support, and we haven't broken that back down just yet. So as we continue to shake off some of this variant news, let's watch that carefully. If that were to fail, we break back down, then we still have this uptrend in here in that could catch us. And we'll want to watch this area. If we were to see some hold or support coming into that chart, it's going to keep those options elevated in price, a little bit of nervousness, wide bid-ask spreads, those kind of things. But watch for that possibility if we have that next shockwave coming in. And what could it be? Could it be Evergrande? Maybe. Could it be the Fed actually ramping up their taper next week? Could it be the CPI coming in on Friday? Who knows, but watch that closely. We have a lot of that uncertainty out there, and we know markets hate uncertainty, so watch that carefully. However, if we were to break this back down, well, hey, if we can break this back down and just say, hey, none of this stuff we're worried about, then who knows, maybe we can shift right on down and be right back up here at new record highs in the market. But we do have some other issues here to consider. Let's take a look at our T21-22. T21-22 is the 4-week new high, new low ratio. And at one point yesterday, we were up here. As I suggested, in a 2-day period, we went from oversold to overbought yesterday. But in that pullback at the end of the day, that opened up a little bit of space here to the upside as we pulled back. So we still have that possibility with the news today, if we can get that bullish encouragement here this morning, that we could pop and continue to run up here into that bearish reversal zone. But watch that carefully, guys. It wouldn't be out of the question to see that pop and drop today where we pop up into these resistance levels, trying to get that energy going, and then see that little bit of a pullback, that rest coming into the market. So watch that closely as we reach up here into that level. Now, we do have to also keep in mind, just like we were able to remain down here in the oversold condition for a period of time, we can remain in an overbought position for a period of time. So it's possible we could pop up in here and just hold for a while as well in a consolidation. So watch carefully. And then if we take a look at our T21-07. Gotta tell you guys, this isn't all that bullish. We certainly have had a nice recovery here the last couple of days. Notice we now have 41% of our stocks, of all of the stocks in the market, above the 200-day moving average. Now that is obviously way better than where we were just a few days ago, but let's also keep in mind, we have quite a few levels of price resistance here we need to break through to move this back into a very, very bullish market. So watch that carefully. We continue to have an awful lot of weight with an awful lot of really ugly looking stocks kind of pulling down on the market. So watch that carefully. If they were to slip and fall, then we may see a little bit more selling coming in. And a retest of lows is certainly always possible. So watch that carefully. And then T21-08, the number of stocks above their 40-day moving average certainly improved a lot the last couple of days. We now have 36%, almost 37% of our stocks above their 40-day moving average. But let's keep in mind where we are. We made new record highs in the market when we were here. And we're looking at possible new record highs in the SPY with this many stocks below their 40-day or just above their 40-day moving average. We've got a lot of stocks below our 40-day. And we continue to try and make these new market highs on a declining number of stocks. So you'll want to keep that in mind and always continue to realize that there's a lot of price resistance in here that we're going to have to get through. I'm not saying we can't do it, but I'm saying that we are extended in the short term and maybe a little rest is due here in the market. And then let's take a look at our T2101. And our T2101, that market breadth hasn't pulled back like we would like to see it. Remember, we were running in this long-term wedging pattern where we were moving up strongly and we could wind up in here and continue seeing that market surge to the upside. Well, now we had that bearish move up here and we spiked up considerably. And notice even yesterday's big move didn't really pull back that market breadth all that much. And that breadth being up in here that high, what we have to worry about is if we were to rest and find support in here, we could certainly spike that back to the upside with a little bit of fear. So watch that carefully. That's where the actual sell-off could really get strong if that were to occur. Just watch that closely. Let's take a look at our economic calendar for today. We have a couple things that we'll want to be paying attention to in that economic calendar. Let's take a quick peek. As you can see, we have those mortgage applications. I haven't seen that come in yet this morning. Should be out here pretty soon. Remember, those have been declining pretty sharply, so that could be a problem for us. We've got the job openings report, and I got to tell you guys, it's kind of remarkable to me that last Friday we pretty much shook off and we're ignoring jobs altogether. That jobs report last Friday was pathetic. And what we may start seeing is this jobs openings report continuing to rise. A lot of employers looking for work, but people aren't taking those jobs. At some point in time, we're going to have to snap that trend. So watch that carefully as that moves. And then, of course, we'll have the petroleum number. We know that the president has opened the strategic reserve a couple of times trying to lower gas prices. So maybe we'll see that decline in supplies help to continue to boost oil prices, and that is going to have that negative impact on inflation if oil continues to move up. So watch that closely. And then we've got jobless claims coming in here on Thursday. That'll be our big market mover potentially there. And then that CPI, which could be a very interesting number here on Friday. What is that inflation doing to us in that CPI read? So watch that carefully. Then let's take a look at our earnings calendar. Our earnings calendar, we have a little bit busier day today with 28 companies listed on the calendar today. And quite a few of those are unconfirmed reports, but we do have some notables here to pay attention to. First off, how about CPB? We've got Campbell Soup that's going to report today. Looks like they're getting a little pop and drop here in that pattern. Campbell's have been in an ugly downtrend. We've kind of slipped out from underneath that downtrend, and I was hoping we'd get a little bit better response. Notice that we're popping above that 50-day moving average. This is that rounded bottom breakout potential pattern. If we can hold that 50, we could start to round this back to the upside, just recovering a little bit. Good defensive sector stock when the market starts getting nervous. Well, defensive sector stocks tend to perk up, so watch that closely. Let's take a look at a couple others here. We're going to hear from GME. Now, if you saw that report yesterday that I mentioned with a lot of CEOs selling, the CEO It's AMC, and I was thinking about another one of the Reddit community stocks. AMC CEO sold a massive amount of shares. So GME is so incredibly elevated here in its share price based on the Reddit community. Watch that pretty closely as that reports. We could see a lot of price movement in that as well. Take a look at LOT will be reporting today. Whoops, LOT. Maybe I typed that somewhere wrong. ALOT. ALOT will be reporting today. Keep an eye on that. We're also going to hear from PLAB. Okay. We have got Restoration Hardware reporting as well, so you'll want to keep an eye on those. And if you want the full list of notables today, make sure you click over there to the blog, and you can pick up that full list of notables. The link is just below the title of the video. So with that, everyone, how about we take a look at some stocks that could be setting up? And before we do that, just really, really quickly here today, if this is the first time you've seen these videos, make sure you click that subscribe button on YouTube, and hopefully you see that these videos are quite a bit different. I don't get involved in the prediction or in the hype. It's really looking at the technicals of the chart. If you find that to be helpful, please make sure you click that bell icon, click that thumbs up button, and leave a brief comment. That helps the channel to continue to grow. And I just want to say thank you to everyone. Remember, Friday, 2:30 p.m. Eastern Time, I'm going to be doing a live stream on YouTube, and we'll be giving away one of my personal carvings. You'll have a choice of a few different things and for reaching that 25,000 level in YouTube. So thank you, everyone. For those who support the channel that way. And also, thank you very much for those who support the channel through the Buy Me a Coffee link. You guys are truly awesome. Thank you so much. I really, really appreciate it. You guys are the best, and thank you. Let's take a look at some of these stocks that could be setting up. Now, please keep in mind, guys, that we've really elevated in this market, and there is that possibility of a rest or pullback coming. So kind of keep that in mind. But because we're so strong in this upside move, I'm going to be sticking with some of the long trades in here today, so keep a close eye. Now, take a look at STX. Now, I had placed a price alert on STX yesterday, the day before yesterday, in that nice little pattern, and STX followed through to the upside, popping through, and it looks like it wants to continue in that move today. So you might want to put that on the list. I think I mentioned this one yesterday. Watch that closely. This looks like it could still have some upside potential in the chart, and looking just pretty darn good here. So watch that closely. Take a look at LAC. Now, LAC had a little volatility here, and we have kind of a double-edged sword here. I said I was going to stick with some bullish charts, but I got to tell you, this one has that chance that it could go either direction. Notice that we broke support here. And one of my rules, when we break support in a chart, we must recover, prove to hold it, so that I can resume that uptrend to the upside. So this has still got some work to do on LAC, but watch that carefully. If that can hold, there may be some upside potential coming in there. But on the same tune, if this were to fail right in here, if we were to push on lower, then I would look for that potential short with a stop loss right above this area in the chart. There's a little bit of back and forth going on in here. Let's take a look at FedEx. For crying out loud, I cannot type today. There we go, FedEx. If you take a look at FedEx in here, this is a nice little recovery. Here again, we broke that support. We've recovered the support in the chart, and now we're trying to rest and hold that level. Let's keep an eye here on FedEx. There may be that opportunity that this does hold, and we can start moving back to the upside, setting that upside trend here. So watch that carefully. Let's take a look at PepsiCo. PepsiCo, I mentioned the last few days, PepsiCo breaking through resistance in the chart, consolidating up here, looking pretty good. I keep a close eye on that for that opportunity that this could move on higher to the upside. I'm also going to put Ford on that list. Ford has been tempting to break out here. We've been trying and trying and trying. A nice little Morningstar pattern in the last three trading days setting up. So can we find the inspiration to move on through and break that resistance to the upside and pop on out? Maybe. Keep a close eye on that. I'm also going to put General Motors on that list. General Motors breaking that downtrend in the chart, pushing back up here towards some price resistance. But one of the patterns, again, that I look for when we break support, break those downtrends, break those resistance levels back up, prove to hold, give me that higher low pattern in here, and I would look for that upside trend to maybe resume in that chart. So watch that closely. So with that, everyone, hey, I want to wish you all the very best. I want to wish you great success in your trading. Thanks so much for being here. I do appreciate it. Have a great hump day, and we'll see you right back here bright and early Thursday morning.